Yes, taste the truth.
I watched as something swam beneath her belly. Her flesh sloughed from the bone and poured forth like mud, drowning the worshippers in a slurry of blood and earth. Birth and death were indistinguishable. I should leave. Find safety. But I dragged myself closer as the prayers of the devout filled my ears. I couldn't lift my sword. I couldn't kill mother and child. When the orders came, I felt pride swell in my chest. Despite my longings, I knew we were superior to these wretched creatures. These swine rutted within cramped, filthy temples. None were more misguided than these madmen, decorated with bones and mud.
Perhaps it's time to make some new memories? Yes, slowly now.
It would be laughable if it were not so lamentable. These so-called seers wield icons and contraptions they do not understand. They uphold laws they ignore as needed. And yet, they unearth a tablet like nothing I'd seen before. Is this what you found? The promise of the unknowable? I know you are awaiting my assailant. I have read how you will descend upon me. I will be too slow to stop you, though I will try. Just know that I do not blame you. I cannot hold on to this body when another will need it far more. We are a single existence, split only by the tides of time, joined together in death.
Perhaps it's time to make some new memories? Perhaps it's time to make... Don't overindulge.
Our venerable order has slaughtered hundreds. And for what? So the magistrate could redraw the borders of our realm? Claim victory over an ill-equipped enemy? Over children who can barely raise their swords?
Perhaps it's time...
vitals and praise a little comfort. No salve can cure my trembling hands or these disquieting dreams. My brethren whisper of redemption. Another way. An immaculate path. Heralded by saints. My vision blurred and went opaque. The whiteness consumed the world, leaving only a vague memory. I felt hands guide me, ushering me away. Something sharp slipped beneath the plates of my armor. I swung out wildly, but my limbs grew heavy as cold crept in. I stumbled and fell, claws searching for the seams between steel and flesh.
There's nothing left, Foundling. You've savored every last drop. Did you miss the sound of my voice? I don't blame you. There's comfort in shared struggle and triumph. Your company is welcome, even if there are no recollections left to stir up. Perhaps it's time to make some new memories? Discovery is its own sort of sacrament, after all. There's nothing left, Foundling. Discovery. Welcome.
I first glimpsed him in a nightmare. Beneath our lead, a dark shape swam. Yet we did not sink. Our swords crossed, but I had a sense that this had all happened before, and would happen again. When I awoke, the scaled ceiling had vanished, only to return in my dreams. The divine is not ours to extract and consume. I tried to warn the others, but their bodies and minds had already been twisted by this blasphemous act. Even the revered reflect their madness, their hate. They are all lost. They drink deeply and forget their names, their purpose, replacing their beliefs with falsehoods. There is only you, unborn. Prepare, for I shall test you. It is as I feared. Solomon is lost. His eyes keep straying to her. The malformed one. He gazes upon her with a madness of hope. I can already see his effect on her. These creatures are in their own fashion, helpless. Our instincts, our memories, even our very forms become theirs in time. Yet they shape us, too, in a cycle forever renewed. I saw him again. The dreamer. He found me in the murky shadows. But this time, it was different. He tore open my skin, wore my flesh like a suit of mail. When I awoke, he slept, as he always did, beneath his sister. But I could feel something inside me changed. I can't explain it, but I must leave.
Your company.
deliver this final glam. Yet, it is I who will ascend, and not those who are worshipped. Hand it over, and claim the honor to witness what's true. Stay back. I will not waste this divine gift. it's all wrong. The visions have dissolved into darkness. There is no ascension. Only an endless abyss, growing deeper and deeper as I stretch my wings uselessly. I've fallen into a sea of shadows. I remember warmth and light, but even that is fading. The visions weren't for me. They were for you. Are you not meant for this blighted place after all? But why should you get to escape while the rest of us remain mired in this miserable pit? It's senseless, this injustice. If I can't ascend, neither will you. No one will. past the threshold, I see nothing now. Nothing at all.
Pray, what wayward spirit beckons? Oh, it's you. Welcome back, Foundling. Yes, it's all happening again. This is the burden of immortality. Toil without end. Our spirits fragmented by the profane eternities. But there's comfort, even a certain pleasure, in ritual. Where were we? Oh, yes. Sip this and you'll see. Yes, taste the truth. Your company is welcome. I see.